Hey everyone, this is Scott from certmedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to install on Cloudways a new WordPress instance. As I showed you in the last video, I showed you how to set up Cloudflare, which is your CDN and DNS provider, but in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can install WordPress on a host, in this case Cloudways. Cloudways is my recommended host because it's fairly inexpensive compared to most on the market, and it has really good performance. I managed to reduce my cost by about 50% for the year compared to Siteground. So I'm going to be showing you how to add an application, and I'm going to be giving you some general pointers to get your domain ready. So what you need to do is you need to click the Add Application menu. This can be done from a number of places, but really what you need to do is on your home page, click on Applications. You're then going to click on the Add Application mark. You're going to go ahead and select the server. In this case, I'm doing it on my personal site's server, so that way it's for my personal websites. How you categorize it is completely up to you. And then you're going to select the application that you're looking to install. If you're looking to install WordPress in general, you can just install the version that it suggests up here. If you're watching this a few months from now, it may be a newer version, such as 5.4, which is the most current version. And if you're looking to have WooCommerce, this will automatically install WooCommerce for you as well. If you're creating a store, it's typically a good thing to have WooCommerce installed because it will make changes to the Varnish cache system. But if you install WordPress and install WooCommerce later, it's no problem. We can easily add that. So what you're going to do is just install version 5.3. And then you're going to name your app. In my previous video, I set up the name servers for a website called Nashville Unbound. And I'm going to call this website Nashville Unbound. And then I'm going to click Add Application. So it's going to go ahead now, and it's going to take about 2 minutes, and it's going to go ahead and install the general application information. But it's a little bit more complicated than that afterwards, but that's okay. We can easily get the domain attached. You see, what it's doing right now is it's setting up an application with a default Cloudways auto-generated domain name. The benefit here is it allows you to get directly working on your website without changing your DNS right away if you're hosted elsewhere, or if you haven't purchased a domain yet, it allows you to easily start experimenting with what you want your website to look like. So what we're going to do is we're going to refresh now just to see if the application has been successfully installed. You shouldn't need to reset the application. It still says it needs about a minute. So while we wait, it looks like our Cloudflare is active for our domain, which is great. We're going to go ahead and close out Google domains now, and we're now going to recheck. It looks like our application was successfully installed. So we're going to go down our application list and see Nashville Unbound. It's in my personal site server, and it was created on April 20, 2020. You're going to click on this application now. As you can see, it did auto-generate itself a URL. What we're going to do is we're going to update this using the domain management tool. You're going to come over to domain management, and then you're going to choose the domain that you want. So as you can see, I'm going to add Nashville Unbound as the chosen primary domain name. If you want it to be www, this is where you add the prefix. So you need to add www.nashvilleunbound if you're looking to have that prefix. Since I prefer the URL to be what's known as naked without the www subdomain, we're going to go ahead and just save it. So while this is happening, what's going on in the background is it's going through and it's trying to set the domain to be, instead of that Cloudways URL, to be Nashville Unbound. It's going to be updating the database, and it's going to be making sure that it can resolve to it. So what we're going to do is now we're going to click on the access details. It says my application domain has been updated, and it's showing in the application URL. So if I click over here, we're just going to validate that it is indeed working. If you get redirected to another website on your account, that does happen sometimes. What you need to do is come over to the Varnish section, and simply, you can disable it for now, or you can go to your server settings and go to manage services and then go to Varnish and click purge. And now we'll go ahead and we'll give it another shot. and now it's resolved to nashvilleunbound.com. If you want to install an SSL certificate, you are able to do so now at this step. All you need to do is provide your email address, as I'll be providing my work address right here. And then we're going to be adding the application name, application domain name. If you're installing subdomains and you want a wildcard SSL, you can do so here. We're just going to be installing a regular SSL certificate for the root of the domain. We're going to go ahead and click install now. And because the website is automatically going to be redirecting from the www version, we're not going to worry about adding the additional domain for it. And we're going to wait while the Let's Encrypt SSL installs, which can take just about normally about a minute, assuming that your DNS is resolving correctly. And then once it is, it's going to prompt you to do an HTTPS redirection. What this does is it's a server-side redirect that forces the application to be accessed via HTTPS instead of HTTP. All you need to click is the Enable HTTPS option. Once it's done, it's going to give you a little bit minute, and then you should be able to go to the website directly. If you access nashvilleunbound.com or whatever your own URL is, you'll see that it's now over HTTPS. There is no broken padlock because it is forcing all URLs to be served, and you can now begin building your website. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.